right, coming up next, it's a middleweight title fight between Anderson the Spider Silva and Dan Hendo Henderson. Looking to become the UFC middleweight champion of the world, here he is, the number one middleweight contender. For a long time, this man has been one of the best 85ers in the world, but this title fight eluded him. It is here right now. He is healthy. He is smack dab in the middle of his prime, and he believes he is the best 85er in the world and is out to prove just that tonight and walk away with 12 pounds of UFC gold. So here's the undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world making the walk, looking to defend his title. It is certainly something that he's been able to do in the past. He has been challenged on this title run. It's not as though he has run roughshod through this division, but they're all still chasing him at 185 pounds tonight. At least on paper, could be his most difficult challenge to date. Now our tale of the tape for this middleweight championship fight. Silva is 1 year the elder. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the introductions, we go to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta. This is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Toyota Center in Houston, Texas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC middleweight championship of the world. Introducing first,
fighting out of the blue corner.
This man is a Greco-Roman wrestler, holding a professional record of 32 wins, 15 losses.
He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Temecula, California, presenting the challenger, Dan Hendo.
And now, introducing the champion,
fighting out of the red corner.
This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 34 wins, 11 losses, and one no contest.
He stands 6 feet 2 inches tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. Fighting out of Curitiba, Brazil, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC middleweight champion of the world, Anderson the Spider Silva!
All right, this is for UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times, and a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves,
tonight we are in Houston, Texas, USA, live from Toyota Center. Good to have you with us tonight. And this building has a lot of history for my man, DC. Pete Gustafson here, Roy Nelson back in the day. We'll see what's in store for these athletes.
This arena has been great for the American Kickboxing Academy. Cain Velasquez was able to retain his title in this arena, too. And also home to the greatest NBA franchise in history, the Houston Rockets. Tonight they will blow. Look, tonight the UFC blows the roof off the building, but every night James Harden and now Russell Westbrook put on a show in this fantastic arena.
Spoken like a true Golden State Warriors fan.
Clutch City, baby. Clutch City.
Right down.
Clutch City, baby.
Which hat you wearing today?
I'm wearing a Rockets. I'm wearing Houston.
Oh, big knee to the body. That'll soften him up.
Oh, big elbow. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the coach.
And both guys really throwing with authority.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, straight right. Oh, big knee to the body. How'd he get that one home?
Oh, man, that leg's all beat up.
How good is that right hand? Silva's got the tie clinched. Let's see what he can do.
Great punch landed with so much power. He's hurt bad.
Under 3 minutes now to go in what has been a very fast-paced opening round here.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick. That one was thrown to end the fight.
Yep. Oh, is that a big knee to the body? We'll see if he can follow up.
Oh, nice
back right. And forth we go. Very nice outside leg kick by him there, DC. We'll see if he follows it up here.
He's really driving his shin into his opponent's side. Beating his
leg. Oh!
What a
goal!
Oh! Oh!
Henderson goes for the clinch here. Looks like he's trying to recover. He was stunned a little bit earlier. Let's see if he can get a respite here. In fight numbers for you now, 29 total strikes have landed for Anderson Silva.
Look at the whip action.
Oh, big knee!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
Seconds to go.
Beautiful body kick land right on the elbow.
And just misses with that big right hand. Silva gets hit with a kick here. Let's see how he responds. Oh, he got that inside leg kick to the target there, DC. You don't want to eat too many of those.
No, you can't. It starts.
Yeah, it looks a little wobbly on his feet.
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Trying to stay in this fight. Oh! Now goes in and secures the takedown. All right, he's in a half-guard position here, DC, and in a good spot to dole out a lot of damage, I would think. A
lot of damage. Now he's chasing the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Looks like it's pretty tight. He's trying to work his head out of harm's way.
It might be over. Oh! Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Not tapping out tonight. Side control now, and certainly I would think more offensive options for the bottom fighter than in the half guard.
Absolutely more offensive options, because now you can just start to get away. You can just go to a wrestler stand-up. Get to your knees, post your hands, don't allow him to get his hooks in, right? Really be aware of the hooks. But get to your hand, stand up, fight the hand, break away and escape. But it's so much more free-flowing than the half guard in the side control, because all you need to do is just get the opponent's body up because his legs are just free to move. His legs are not controlling anything. His legs are just free. So you have more freedom to use yours.
All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. We had a knockdown there, but not a knockout.
No, it wasn't a knockout, but you can't take those shots. That big punch landed, and it sat him down. If he gets hit with another one of those, it might be good night, Irene.
Okay, ready? Two, ready?
All right, let's get to round two. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Silva, lands flush.
Very tricky when he throws that body kick. That was a thudding leg kick.
And he lands a punch there. Pretty good connection by him.
Great connection. He's in a great flow right now.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're going to have to put something on your opponent that's going to really make him pause. I believe the jab has been working so well, if he drops a big right hand after it, he may be able to finish his fight. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
His misses are entertaining. Oh, nice connection by him there with the right hand.
The right hand is the dominant hand, and you can see how well he throws it. He's throwing bombs. Every time they come into contact, he's throwing bombs.
Oh, bleeding from his cheek now. Damage done. Man, it's almost like he's got a range finder out there.
Great timing on that move to take
down. All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra hop in your step when you talk about fighters working out of this.
So he's going to attack a triangle choke here. Oh! Now he falls back into the finishing position.
Submission defense there. Ooh, right into side control, DC.
This is where you want to be now because you get to make your opponent decide. They try to turn back into you to attack.
That one appeared to stun him.
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Big knee lands there. Landed for Anderson the Spider Silva. And the accuracy rate about 42% now against Anderson Silva. Under 2 minutes to go. Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he is...
Oh! He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, straight right.
Down landing clean.
Nice land there by Anderson Silva. Just a true mixed martial artist. Has so much honor and respect for the game. And somewhat remarkable, still getting it done when matched up with the best middleweights in the world. Just out of range with the big right hand. Well-placed kick there by Silva. Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. And they separate. Nice shot to the body there. Looked like it did stun him a little bit.
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Oh, big left hook there. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Anderson's lower jaw does not look good. I don't think it's broken, but starting to show some obvious signs of swelling. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. 30 seconds to go in round two. Oh, spinning back kick. He didn't telegraph that one at all.
back in the clinch, looking for tape. Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down.
Oh, he might be out.
Big kick lands.
What a fight so far. All right, the round is over. Gut check time for him now. You see the cut on his cheek has gotten really, really bad. And even though it's not affecting his vision, if it gets any worse, the doctor will be called in. And I can assure you, he's going to have no choice but to stop this fight. All right, so a big knockdown for him courtesy of that punch in that round. DC, here's your replay.
Big moment in the previous round. They were both fighting very well, but when he landed this punch right here that sits his opponent down, it showed that the power is not equal, and if he can land, he does have the ability to damage him.
Let's fight. All right, here we go with this third round of this championship fight. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here. Oh, lands a stiff punch there. Nice connection.
Oh, nice land.
Oh, collar tie. Wow!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Silva gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Got a single collar tie.
He's grabbing the back of the head, pulling forward on the head, and then landing those beautiful punches. Really's got his opponent on notice here.
Oh, and he connects there. Pretty nice punch there.
Great job finding the range to land those punches.
All right, so a knockdown for him in the previous round, and you can just see by his body language how confident he is in the striking realm in this match.
And you can see his confidence in his body.
Oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Again, the fighters engage in the clinch. We'll see who will have the upper hand here, champ.
There are so many options to dictate and control this exact.
Oh!
Holy smoke! He put him to sleep.
Oh, he dove and he lands. Wow! All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Oh, it looks like he's transitioning to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. Oh, wow, oh!
Continuing to try to manipulate the head here. And this might just be a matter of time. There it is, so he taps out due to the armbar tonight.
Snapping his arm. Right. Sometimes it's better to lose and fight another day, but that's all to this fighter on a great submission victory.
All right, let's take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He was able to get the fight to the ground exactly where he wanted it. Eventually, his opponent gave him an opportunity to get a submission. He did that, and he should be very proud of the work he did tonight in the octagon.
Well, you're going to have to be pretty perfect to get this guy off the throne. There he is, the UFC's undisputed middleweight champion. Complete performance here tonight, and it ends with a win by way of submission.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta is going to stop this contest at 2 minutes, 15 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by tap out due to an armbar, and still the undisputed UFC middleweight champion.
So there he is, the still UFC middleweight champion of the world. He has retained this title at 185 pounds for some time and showing no signs of slowing down.
This is a weight that hasn't had many middleweight champions. Anderson Silva reigned for so long that every time a guy gets his hands on the belt, They're going to hold on to it for dear life. And tonight.